Yeah, that my tribe. Yeah. Hey, what's up, y'all? This is the Mother's House Podcast, and I am Cousin D. Sean.
What's up, everyone? My name is Corey. Peace to you and everyone that you love. What's going on with my cousin?
Chilling. What's going on with you?
Man, chilling. Just trying to work on this car right now.
Okay.
Everything's all copacetic.
That's what's up. So Jidenna has put out a couple of new songs.
It's been about 3 years since he dropped something, right?
It's been a while. Yeah, it's been a while. Well, first of all, the new songs are Tribe and Sufi Woman.
Yeah, it's coming off his new album, supposed to drop sometime this month, I think the 23rd of this month. 85 to Africa.
Right. I guess with that, I don't know. But I really like the video for Tribe. It made me want to buy that house. I want that house. It looked fun.
Stripper poles and everything, huh?
And swings.
And swings. Okay, that's a good conversation. Yeah, I like the song Tribe. When I first heard it, I was like, he giving me great vibe, but his vibe has always been like that to me.
Right.
To a certain degree. But I don't know if it's the mixed heritage, the Simpson colored Negro vibe.
Not a mulatto vibe. That's offensive to somebody. Okay.
It is what it is. There's nothing wrong with people who are mulatto. I'm just talking trash. But I like the song Tribe. Tribe was a good song. I like the song. Is it a standout for me? Not really.
Right.
I mean, the thing with Jidenna, man, I think he really missed his mark after he dropped Classic Man. Like, he waited too long to drop the album. I don't know if that's what's on him or on the label.
Yeah, you never know, politics, you know.
The politics of that. Like, I think Jidenna is very talented. I do too. If his timing was right, he would be even a bigger artist now. You know what I'm saying? And him waiting 3 years to drop his latest project now.
I'm expecting more from him.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Than what he produced, what he put out with this song.
Not that it's bad.
Not that it's bad. It sounds like he could have been on his last one.
Right. Well, I feel like I do think Jidenna is talented. I also think Jidenna is a place for him because I think he's a unique artist. I don't think it's really anyone like Jidenna. As far as the songs themselves, I like them. They're not really standout songs. They're more so feel good songs. If it's playing on my playlist, you know what I'm saying? I like this song. I'm not about to start a playlist about this song. You see what I'm saying? It's not going to be like a lead song, but I still like the song. It's not a very strong song, but I feel like he's trying to chill and not do too much, and that's what the song is giving for me. I am up tired of that. It's weird. It's almost like I can tell when someone is an Americanized person trying to do Afrobeat or trying to do reggae or it's almost like Americanized reggae or Afrobeat or whatever that shit is has its own sound now.
Is it like Denzel Washington trying to play a Jamaican in I forget the name of that movie. Like American person trying to imitate a Jamaican accent.
It's like you can tell. At first I couldn't tell, but now that sound is now has been out from, you know, Drake just wore it out.
I mean, Drake is the cultural appropriator of
every. He just destroyed that sound.
He just stole everybody.
Right.
fail.
And it's like a couple of artists have played with it. Beyonce played with it.
Wouldn't he be able, like, Jidenna? Because he's half Nigerian.
I'm not saying anyone can't do anything. I'm just saying what is coming out is a sound that I'm tired of hearing.
Okay, you just tired of that sound.
Yeah, it's like.
So you tired of Afrobeat?
No, but I like Afrobeat. Like, it's almost like maybe it's because I'm mature and I'm beginning to distinguish the difference between Afrobeat or when that sound is a little bit more organic versus when someone is American and they're like putting accents into their music and making it sound like that.
Oh, okay, I gotcha. Yeah. I didn't really get that vibe from it. Mm-hmm. From that or Sufi. I actually like Sufi Woman.
I like both of them, but
Sufi Woman is a dope track too. Both of the tracks are cool. I'm just scared that his album if that's his two songs, right? Mm-hmm. I just feel like both of these songs could have been on his first album. Forget the name of the album, but it sounds very familiar, you know what I'm saying? It sounds just like that same sound, and maybe that's just his trademark. That's like, you know, certain artists have a signature sound to them, you know what I'm saying? Well, and maybe that's his signature sound, you know, how he approaches his music. You dig what I'm saying?
Right, I understand that. But I think he can do more than that.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Like, I know he's very talented. I think he can do a little bit more than what he's given, and mind you, these just two songs. We haven't heard the album, I liked Jidenna last album. I didn't dislike it. Was it my favorite album of that year when it dropped? But it wasn't bad at all. Yeah. It let me know, okay, I can see where he can go with it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's surrounded by very creative people. He's a creative person as well, and a person that speaks out and speak up for, you know, on social issues and all that. But the Tribe video, I really enjoyed.
Yeah,
I did enjoy the Tribe video. I think that Jidenna is one of those artists. I think Jidenna will be more appreciated when his time weighs down. You get what I'm saying? That's why I said, like, he should have came out hard swinging after he brought Classic Man. Classic Man was such a big record.
Because this happens, like, sometimes you don't know what things happen in the background. Who's to say that now he's not in a better place, that he can't consistently put music out and have a place, you know, in music again?
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping that this project will do for him. Don't get me wrong, every artist, you know, like we said on the last podcast about the indie artist scene, indie artists or people who are not as the popular mainstream, who are not the mainstream artists, are getting a lot of shine and getting a lot of looks, and because they have their own following behind them. Like, right. You gotta have a following behind them.
Exactly. Like, you can do a lot of music nowadays.
Yeah. He's straight regardless, because he can tour off the music he makes. You know what I'm saying? Right. With, you know, his last album and these two songs and this project too. So, you know, people are going to look forward to listen to him. You know, it's just the fact that, like,
you think he missed his moment?
I can say that. Yeah, I think he missed his moment. But I also think he probably where he kind of really want to be. I don't think he probably one of those artists that, like, he not really caring to be in the limelight.
Like a Frank Ocean type deal. When Frank Ocean was getting too big, he kind of went into hiding.
Yeah. It's kind of like that. I think Frank Ocean is a bigger artist than Jidenna.
Well, I'm just saying his situation, far as when he was, like, starting to, you know, get popular or whatever, he kind of...
Yeah, he saw where he could go. He was like, nah, I ain't trying to go that route.
As far as we know. Yeah. Okay, you know.
As far as we know. We don't know this brother from a can of paint.
You know what I'm saying? Okay.
Yeah. But I think Jidenna, his music is very upbeat. You know what I'm saying? Very, is a vibe to
it. And I've always liked Jidenna's music. Like, even though I'm not super into Jidenna like that, but whenever he put out a song, it'd be good. Like, I bop to it. And it is kind of the same sound.
Like I said, man, it's not like you're going to just a throwaway from his last album.
I really like that song.
I wouldn't even call it a throwaway. I think it should have been on his last album.
You know what song I like from Jidenna? That song goes, and a little bit more. They don't know how you like. You know that song?
I don't know that
okay.
one.
But see, with that being said, I like Jidenna. I do. So this is in no way a diss. I know people going to take words and like...
Hey, we're going to do a review on the album. We still got to do a big crit review. We got some reviews to do. But when it comes to Jidenna, man, I think lyrically, I prefer Jidenna over Drake.
That's saying a lot. I think Drake is good lyrically.
Yeah, he decent.
He's not so fast.
He's cool. I mean, I get why people like Drake. You know what I'm saying? But I also know why people like Jidenna. You know what I'm saying? So, if I had to pick between Drake or Jidenna, I'd probably go with Jidenna. You know.
So, you think Drake and Jidenna are kind of in the same lane?
Singy, rapping type of rappers who can really rap. And also... I think Jidenna do better singing than Drake.
I agree with that, yeah. So is Jidenna like a underground Drake or like a more soulful Drake?
Even more well-established musically, Drake.
How would he be more well-established musically? You mean far as his style or because Drake is...
I'm talking about the musicality. Like, Jidenna seem like the type of brother who come out there, rap a couple of bars and pull out a piano and start singing. Banjo and start singing.
Okay,
Drake ain't about to do that.
You think he's a little bit more musically inclined. But I mean...
More musically inclined, yeah.
I mean, you don't know that.
I don't know that, but... That's the vibe he gives off. You know what I'm saying? And I don't know if Drake can do that.
Right.
Like, surprise everybody come out here singing. I don't know. If he can manipulate the what is it? The Texas sound. If Drake manipulates Chopping Screw music, who say he can't go out there and do some Billy Ray Cyrus type music too?
Right. But all in all, I do feel like when it comes to artists missing their mark, I think you can make another moment. I don't think you're confined to one moment.
But no, not at all.
I would say he probably has his work cut out for him. But at the same time, you don't know what he wants. He may be in a good place. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I think. I think Jidenna is where he wants to be. I don't think Jidenna wants to be... I don't know if he chose to wait that long to push his music out. Between when he first dropped Classic Man to Dead, because he was doing a lot of interviews, he just wasn't dropping no music.
Did he put out an album in between that?
He didn't. He just dropped a. He might have dropped an EP.
Okay, so maybe he just. Okay, maybe it was an EP, or maybe it was. It must have been an EP. Because I know that song In a Little Bit More came out after that.
It did. That must have been an EP, because that did come after the album.
Right.
It had to, because I didn't hear that song. But it wasn't on the album. I know it wasn't on the album, because I would have remembered that.
Okay, so it was an EP. It was an EP called Boomerang.
Oh, yeah. I do remember Boomerang.
How was that?
I do. It was all right. It just...
You don't remember it, so it wasn't that distinct.
Yeah, it wasn't that distinct. Like I said, it's like, when it comes to Jidenna, it's like, if you're a fan of, you know, the Wonderland music artists and Wonderland movement, you might rock really heavy with Jidenna and his music. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. If you're not, if you're like a casual listener like I am, it's all right. It ain't bad.
Some artists give different vibes. Some artists kind of understand their fans or whatever, and they have the relationship where they kind of just give the fans what they want. Maybe some artists just do what works.
Yeah, maybe and, that's what he doing was work. Or and not trying to do too much experimenting. Like, right, okay.
Not everyone's that artist that's going to experiment and try new different things and flip the script and do this. Some people just do what they do, you know?
Well, do you think, like, for instance, like, That's My Tribe, is that a little more trap type of sound? What kind of sound would you get at? It's not trap, I don't think it's trap.
I don't
trap,
know what it is. It's familiar.
It's very familiar. Yeah. That's what I'm saying. That's one aspect I like about the song, that is familiar. The hook is catchy. Song's a little short.
But at the same time, are you like saying the song is too familiar and too similar to what you already have seen?
Yeah. That's why it's not a standout to me.
And that's why I think we both kind of feel like if we heard it in the playlist, we'll keep bobbing.
Yeah, it wouldn't skip a playlist. Yeah, if I heard it on the radio, if I'm listening on Pandora, which I don't, and it pop up, cool. But it's not, if I really like a song, it goes on my personal playlist. Like, okay. I create my own playlist. And neither one of these songs made the cut to go on my playlist. But I do really enjoy Tribe and Sufi Woman. Right. You know what I'm saying? And I think he has it in him to make songs and be like, whoa, he really did his thing on the song. And I want to see, I'm interested in who he's going to collaborate on this project, who he's going to collaborate with, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, Jidenna dope. He's a talented artist. He's very talented. And he been gone for a minute, so I would think he'll have something to give more than what he's been giving on these two tracks. You know what I'm saying?
Well, it's still early, so we'll find out.
Cause like with Superwoman, it sound like Bambi to me.
Okay.
You remember the song Bambi? He got a video and all that. Mm-hmm. It kind of sound like Bambi to me. And I think it's a similar kind of subject matter as well. So it's like, okay, we telling the same subject matter, but we're not doing nothing new with it. You know what I'm saying?
That's
so
all
I'm
you like, got? Yeah. Like but you know what? I ain't even trying to diss nobody, but some people have gotten away with that for a long time.
Most artists. That's why the music's kind of stagnant nowadays.
I feel like you have like a couple of artists who top themselves.
Big name artists that do that.
Right, you have big name artists. You have big name artists who do that, and you have artists who, to me, are the better artists, and that's my opinion.
Yeah.
Who try different stuff, who top themselves, who outdo themselves, who give you something new, give you something different, give you something fresh. But you know what? Whatever works. That's all I got to say.
Yeah. And like we said, you know, when we do these reviews, music is subjective.
Right.
It's very subjective. It depends on the listener is. You know, some people think scoopity doop 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 doop.
You know,
bullshit is the hottest shit ever. So, right. Yeah, so.
And just because you try different shit don't mean you good, man. Don't mean it's all gonna
be exactly.
Good.
Very much true, man. But, you know, what I'm saying, I want him to experiment more. It's not saying I want him to go outside his box. You know what I'm saying? Outside. Just stretch a little bit outside your comfort zone. You know what I mean?
Right.
Well, I would like to see him do a project, do a song with Jidenna and JID, do a song together. That'll pull him outside his comfort zone. You know what I'm saying? Will it make a better song? I don't think so. It just depends on what they go with. But I would like to see him go outside his comfort zone and be like, yo, but to make us dance, like, I can really do this shit if I really wanted to. I just choose not to. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Maybe need some people around him who can push him a little bit more and make him grow a little bit more.
Well, I mean, like, that's the thing.
Again, we assume.
Yeah, that's the thing. Musically, I don't know if that's what he want to do. I think he's trying to. I think with Wonderland, they trying to stick to a particular narrative, a particular message, and they all trying to confide and make that message known. I think that's what he's doing. He doing his role. And trying to push that message. You got Jidenna, they doing her thing, trying to push the message, and then Saint Beauty and the other artists, you know what I'm saying? So I think they all trying to stay within their
lane. I'd get tired of that, but you know, I mean.
Yeah, that's me. That's what I'm saying. I would get tired of that too, you know what I'm saying? And them coming off the cuffs of like the Outkast, the Dungeon Family Clique, like I think y'all need to branch out a little bit.
Who are extremely experimental and some of the best artists, you know, we've seen in like the past, I don't know how long, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, over 2 decades, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, and I ain't saying they gotta be like on the Outkast level type of thing, because Outkast wasn't doing it for like recognition or nothing like that. But who to say he don't have something like that on this album? Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, if I was to listen to this album, and these his two weakest songs on the album,
right,
everything else is jamming, I'm gonna be like, this is dope, man. This could have potential to be a classic. You know what I'm
and
saying?
And you know, when it comes to experimenting and doing different, like everybody, and this is not a slight, but everybody's not that artist. And I know I kind of just said that because I think about, I'm not trying to make it about me, I'm not, but I think about myself, and it's like, you have to have a
selfish.
No, right? Here we go. Here the fuck
we go. Here we go. I'm always about to try to hit you. Me when you drop it out.
Right. But I feel like it has to start with the desire to do different things.
Right, yeah.
And you know,
to branch out and experiment. Right,
like, and you still don't know. Maybe he tried to do different things. Maybe the label was like, just do what worked. That happens too.
Yeah.
You know, that happens to a lot of artists. A lot of artists have a lot of stories about how they tried to get outside of their norm, and the label say, no, we just want you to do this because this is what you do, and you already got that established, and that's all you're going to do.
And then also, you want to cater to your fan base. Jidenna fan base is black women. You know what I'm saying? Black women love Jidenna. You know what I'm saying? And also, you know, He has a very niche fan base.
I think you know the same fan base is Drake.
Well, that's black women. I
would just say Drake's fan base is bigger, but
he's more well known. He touched on a lot more superficial shit. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of superficial people like superficial shit. And Jidenna, he's more of a worldly artist. Like I can see him not being as big. He'd be as big as he is here in America now, but overseas, or in Africa and in UK, he might be the biggest big ass Drake over there. You know what I'm saying? He give me more of a worldly artist, a worldly type of artist. But here in the States, you know, people listen. You know, it's a little different here.
Yeah.
How you get popping over here. Mm. You know what I'm saying? And nowadays, it's all about the antics and more so about the antics than the music. You know what I'm saying? I think the problem with Jidenna is that his music is not as big as it was outside everybody else's antics. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
If that makes any sense to anyone out there, I think but I think he's talented enough to outshine all that antics. I think people should listen to Jidenna. Jidenna's dope. I mean,
so I think at the end of the day, we're basically saying that he has potential.
Basically, yeah. Are you excited for his album, 85 to Africa?
I'm sure.
I wouldn't say I'm excited, but I would definitely give it a listen because I respect and I fuck with Jidenna. But excited? No, I was excited for Big Crit though. Very excited for Big Crit.
That's what it is.
That's what it is.
If y'all listen to the album or to the songs, let us know what you think. Let us know what you thought about our conversation. You know what I'm saying? Feel free, if you agree or disagree, to leave whatever comment you want to leave. You know what I'm saying? Subscribe. Turn your notifications and share, and thank you so much.
Yeah, thank y'all, man. Black is great. Okay, right. All right. Just hit that subscribe button and we'll catch y'all on the flip side.
I will not raise my daughter differently than my mother raised me. The rearing I got from my mother, words cannot express. I could live in any time, I could live in any country, I could live on any planet, and I would be fine.
What was the key? What did your mother know? What truth was coming through your mother that's going to come through you to your daughter?
My mother gave us aphorisms to learn as children. And the one that I, there are two that stand out foremost in my mind. One is the inner reality creates the outer form. I learned this when I was in grade school. I was very young. And the other is the universe bears no ill to me. I bear no ill to